Coming up next, it's a UFC light heavyweight division encounter. Well, this young man is a really accomplished submission specialist, and sometimes fighters get offended when you call them a specialist, but most people know what he's trying to do in there, and to this point, no one's really been able to stop him.
John, he will try to pull guard. Yeah. He pulls guard anymore in the UFC at this point, but he understands that for him to be successful, the fight has to be in the grappling, in the jiu-jitsu. If he's able to extend these jiu-jitsu exchanges, he is the guy that is generally going to win. He understands position. He understands going from point A to point B. He always is the one controlling the underhook. Always has the frame. Just a knowledge of jiu-jitsu that not many people can match.
And you can be sure as he makes this walk tonight, he's thinking about just how quickly he can get this fight to the ground and utilize those aforementioned high-level submission skills. Well, we probably trot out the term well-rounded in modern-day mixed martial arts more than we should, but this fighter certainly fits the bill.
Oh, 110%. He can do everything inside the octagon. Where he is most comfortable is inside of that eight-sided structure where most men are terrified of being. But for this gentleman, he only wants to be there. When you try to wrestle him, he's able to defend takedowns. If you dare stand and strike with him, he can knock you out. He's got all the tools necessary to become a UFC champion.
His first martial art, mixed martial arts, and that's not always the case. He believes that he should have a lot of advantages in this matchup tonight. Our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight tilt. Cannonier is 14 years the elder. Same numbers on reach. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a freestyle fighter. Make his professional debut here tonight. He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Pantera. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 16 wins, 6 losses. He stands 5'11" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Glendale, Arizona, USA, Jared the Killer Gorilla Cannonier. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Loving.
The veteran Eve Loving draws the assignment here.
You ready?
All right, so here we go with round one. The tension is palpable. On one side, you've got one of the more well-rounded fighters in this game. Oh! Oh, straight right. This might just be a matter of time. Wow. All right, working inside the closed guard now. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Closed guard here. He's very comfortable here working off of his back, DC. Pretty good work with the strikes here off of his back by Cannonier. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice.
Nice right here.
We cross the midpoint in round one.
Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Back to the jab now, no good. 2 minutes remain in the round. Single collar tie now. takes the shot.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? He blocks the punch. Oh, he's got that right hand going tonight, DC. Connected with it there.
He's thrown so many left jabs to throw that right punch straight down the pipe. It's unreal. Nice.
Slips.
He's hurt bad.
So under 30 seconds to go in what has been a pretty entertaining and active first round. Straight right. That is a huge shot right there, DC. You don't want to eat too many more of those.
No, and he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
All right, so there's the end of the round. He stayed committed to doing damage upstairs and landed a seminal blow in that round.
It was accumulation of those strikes. He kept hitting him over and over to the head. Eventually, he found the one that really did damage his opponent.
You ready? You ready?
Fight. Ooh, head kick lands. It's hurt.
Ooh, he landed a huge hook there. Well, not much of a setup there. Misses with the left hook. Oh! Oh, there, DC. He is officially rocked.
A big, massive hook that really has put his opponent on skates.
Slips that left hand. Cannonier gets tagged with a kick now. Let's see if he can rally. Beautiful straight counter. All right, well, he's landed some good shots tonight, but there's no three-piece, there's no soda. More often than not, it's one and done.
He's not even getting a combination. He didn't like that left hand. He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
That uppercut is good.
And you hear the crowd react every time they come together because they understand the power that these guys are striking with. What a punch.
And both guys really throwing with authority. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. All right, so a nice shot there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot.
Point accuracy on that punch right there. His opponent's compromised, DC.
It's one thing to land a hard shot. It's another thing completely to land a perfect shot. And that was a perfect shot.
Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. So a much different approach for him here in the second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of a feeling out process. Now he has clearly found his...
Oh! What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Trying to establish that jab once again. Whoa!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Able to check that kick as well. Close guard now. You gotta be careful though. He's got a lot of submissions off his back. What a round. All right, right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of there.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands, his opponent's on wobbly legs. That is exactly what you want to see as you're walking back to your stool. Your opponent staggering back to his corner and being hopeful that he can get it back together before the start of the next round.
Well, put that size to good use, and he certainly did so there.
Serve him up. Go get him. That jab hurt him.
All right, single collar tie now. He is so sound defensively. Nice job to raise the guard there.
It's the relaxation that allows him to see things coming and block most of the strikes that are coming at him. Nice loop and punch.
Oh, he landed another great shot to the body there. Really starting to connect at a high percentage now in the latter stages of this fight. Oh, killer jab there from Jared Cannonier. Amazing to think where he would have been had he gotten an earlier start at MMA. He's only been at this for a few years and obviously has realized incredible results.
It's scary, right? It's scary.
Oh!
He's done. He's hurt bad. Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
All right, he's got the full mount now. Is this one of the most dominant positions in MMA? Is that fair to say?
It's a very dominant position. It's one of the most ideal positions you can get to, especially if you are fighting someone that doesn't truly understand that they're not in as much danger as they are. Because it's dangerous, but there are a lot of outs. And if a person isn't very understanding of that, then you can really, really put some damage on
it. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
Just out of range with that right hook. Oh, he's really starting to apply pressure on his opponent here. Different approach here in the last couple rounds. And it's the exact sense of urgency that you want to see from a fighter. Take the judges out of it.
Massive hook lands, and his opponent seems to be on his way out of the fight.
So, fighter a little bit stunned, holding on to him now, not doing a ton, just looking to recover. Oh!
Look at that. The trouble's over. It's over. He got him!
Just the way he drew it up as he gets the knockout victory here tonight, it's hard to land a strike more flush than he did right there, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming. So he'll see the replay and probably shake his head, but ultimately this is a huge result and a huge win for that fighter here tonight. So a huge result and a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the big knockout win. That could hold up as one of the better KOs of the year.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 27 seconds of round number 3, declaring the winner by knockout, Pantera!
Well, he's smiling ear to ear, and why not after a knockout like that? I need a ticket to the after party tonight.
I mean, this is what dreams are made of. You dream of a knockout like this, and then the party after, where you and all your coaches get to celebrate the great handiwork. Between the zombie apocalypse and the bomb, you know, right meaning which is popular, same.